Exciting times for the Fremantle Dockers. The president, Steve Harris, has been really kind to join us on Footy WA. Steve, welcome and congratulations on the season to date. It's an exciting time for Fremantle.
Thank you, it is.
Do you feel like you're in the zone to win your first historic premiership?
Oh, look, you're getting a bit premature there, aren't you? Still haven't finished the home and away season, but we're feeling good. We think we've got a lot of improvements to deliver and, you know, we'll focus on the next three games first.
The last few weeks have been a little challenging and tough, for, I think, for all the top sides as they try and get through the season. Obviously, you've pretty much banked top spots, so it's been less need to be at the top of your game. Do you think you've got a team that's good enough to win? Like, most of the top four sides have got strengths and weaknesses. Do you think you've got a team that's strong enough to deliver on the big day, last day in October?
Look, it's a long way away, and I'm not going to get drawn in speculating on that yet. Certainly, I think we've got a lot of improvement. If you look at the way we played at the start of the season, the way we played in the last few weeks, I think there's improvement there. The coaches certainly think there's improvement as well. So my view would be we can get better.
Steve, regardless of whether the club wins a premiership this year or not, it's obviously in contention. Where to post this season? We're just having a look at some of the senior players. McFarlane, 34, Pavlich, 33, Sandilands, 33, and I'm sure you're aware of all of that. Where to for the club post this season?
Oh, I think we've got a lot of young talent coming through. And if you look at, you know, particularly some of the young kids coming out of Peel, this year and last year, some of the debutants we've had, we've got a lot of talent coming through. So I'm not of the view that you have to go through this cycle where you're on top and then all of a sudden you're down the bottom. I think in the last decade, clubs are proving that cycle's not necessarily true. So in our view, the line we've coined is sustained success, and our view is to keep going.
Is Ross Lyon your long-term coach, given that? Do you think you've got a window there where you can contend for 3 or 4 years? And if so, will you look to extend his contract in the off-season?
Look, it's still pretty early. I think he's through to the end of 2017 at the moment. He's doing a great job. There's a long future there for him, the way it's going at the moment.
Has the Peel Thunder relationship been ideal, Steve? Or do you need to have your own team? Or has it worked out nicely?
Look, it's been critical. We looked 4 or 5 years ago and we said, what is the most critical things that we can do to secure the future of the club? And one of the things was our new training and admin facility, and the other was a place where our young players could grow and develop and play as one. And it's delivered in spades for us, and it can only continue to get better. It's still the second year of the formal partnership, and we think it's got a long way to go.
Well, have a look at your new facility here as we chat. This is going to be unbelievable for you, isn't it?
Yeah, it'll be incredible. $105 million plus facility shared with the local community. The locals come down, have a swim in the pool. They'll be swimming next to Nat 5 Stephen Hill. We're expecting over 1 million visitations a year from the general public through the shared facility. So it's a critical part of our future. In our view, it'll be the benchmark in the AFL.
And what about the new stadium? Because it's such a big investment, and it will be so magnificent if the economic model works. But from the outside, it looks like there's a lot to get through there, because we saw the challenges in Adelaide with Adelaide and Port. You've got a really favourable stadium deal now, like the West Coast Eagles have, and the economics don't seem like they work at the moment. Are you certain you can get through it to make the move?
Yeah, we're really confident. There's a number that we can afford to pay, and we can't afford to go over that. And it's just about how we do the deal and how we share the risk. The negotiations are taking a long time, but that's because there's no urgency to it. We're not going to play there for a few years yet, and we want to make sure we do the right deal. And the government is all about making sure we've got the right deal as well. It's not in their interest to drive a deal where that's not profitable for us. We're a skinny business financially. We budget for profits of sub $500,000, sort of less than 1% of our turnover. So we can't afford to pay out outrageous rents or anything like that. We can afford to pay what we can afford to pay.
Steve, a lot of very passionate Fremantle supporters out there, and they are a very passionate group, I guess, wanting to know, you talk about sustained success, where else does the club need to improve over the next 5 to 10 years to have that level of success?
Look, it's not exciting to talk about the off-field stuff, but once we're in one of the best facilities in the AFL, then we need to talk about building our balance sheet and being financially successful for the long term. But I come back to what we've achieved and what we haven't achieved. We've still got to get some silverware in the cupboard. That's the big goal. That's what we need as a club to, I guess, to make a statement. And people say, oh, the Dockers have arrived, you know, the Dockers have changed. And my view is we've got to stay hungry, and that's the benchmark. That's what we've got to deliver for the supporters.
Can you get a key forward this off-season?
Look, you never know. We're always looking. I'm not in the business of speculating on which players we talk to and which players we don't. But, we've also got some young players who are coming through as well. You would have seen people like Hannah Pierce, who are delivering in the forward line as well.
The free agency experience with Sylvia obviously didn't work. It hasn't left you with your fingers burnt over the whole free agency? Will you go in again and have a go?
No, I think the thing with trading and players is you can't become risk averse. Anything you do in football involves risk. And so our view is we're still out there. I think Chris described us on radio a couple of years ago as the Tyrannosaurus Rex of clubs in terms of being out there looking for players, and we're certainly in the market.
Oh, I'm sure that made sense somewhere in your world, Chris. But
haven't you seen Jurassic Park?
Steve, thanks for coming in. Well done all the work you've done leading the Dockers. New facility, new stadium, and hopefully new era of premiership success. Good luck for the finals.
Great, thank you.
Steve Harris joining us, the president of the Fremantle Football Club here on Footy WA. More after the break, including all the waffle action next.